The factorization, one more method, that is the completing the square method. So first one example I will take and make you sure that you will understand this. First equation is x square plus 4x minus 5 is equal to 0. This is of course a quadratic equation. How to find the factors? By completing the square now. So first, in this quadratic equation, you see the middle term sign. The middle term sign is plus here. So you go for the formula a plus b whole square. What is a plus b whole square? It is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So first thing, you see the sign of the middle term. If it is plus, go for a plus b whole square. If it is minus, go for a minus b whole square. So now, here x square means a square plus 2 comes from the formula, and in the place of a you have x. Now in the middle term you have 4x. So in 4x you have only 2 here. So what the term you have to take now? If you want to get here 4x, you have to multiply once again 2 for that. Means what? 4x is equal to 2 you have. If it want to go for 4x means multiply again 2 here. And here minus 5 is equal to 0. So now, 1 minute here, be careful here. Minus 5 is equal to 0 before writing. You make sure that you got a square plus 2ab. According to the formula, plus b square you have to write, no? So write plus, in the place of b you have 2. So b square means 2 square. And normally in the quadratic equation, minus 5 was there, you write that 5. And the external term what you have taken additionally, 2 square, that is 4 you have taken, that you subtract, minus 4, which is equal to 0. This is how you have to split and write. Basically, if in the middle term plus sign is there, means go for the formula a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Now start splitting and writing this. X square as it is you write, in between plus sign is there, you also write plus sign. Now according to the formula 2 must come, so 2, in the place of a you have x, so that is x. But here you have 4x, here only 2x is there, so you have to multiply 2 for that, so that the middle term also becomes 4x. Then afterwards a square plus 2ab you got, you have to go for b square, in the place of b you have 2, so b square means 2 square. And in the quadratic equation, minus 5 is there, but additionally you have taken plus 2 square, that is 4. So minus 4 you write, equate it to 0. Now from here to here it is just like a plus b whole square. In the place of a you have x, and in the place of b you have 2. So it becomes x plus 2 whole square up to here. Minus, now these two if you take, minus 5 minus 4 gives you the value minus 9, which is equal to 0. Now later on, x plus 2 whole square, you keep this side, take minus 9 to that side, it will become 0 plus 9, which is equal to 9. Now you want only x plus 2. X plus 2 is equal to square root of 9. That can be plus 3 or minus 3. Now x plus 2 can be plus 3 or x plus 2 can be minus 3. From this, if you take 2 to that side, 3 minus 2, which is equal to 1. So your answer, x is equal to 1 you got. Or from this, if you take 2 to that side, already minus 3 is there, plus 2 going to that side becomes minus 2. Minus 3 minus 2 gives you minus 5. Therefore, x is equal to minus 5. So your roots will be x is equal to 1 or minus 5. This is your final answer. So how to take the completing the square method? Once again, make sure the middle term is plus or minus, and use the proper formula a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square. Then split the terms, x square as it is you write, according to the formula 2 must come, in the place of a it is x, But here 4x is there, so naturally you have to multiply 2. So now the value of b becomes 2, so write b square has 2 square. And minus 5 is in the equation, write minus 5. Additionally, you have taken 2 square, so subtract minus 4. Now from here to here, it gives you the x plus 2 whole square. Minus 5 minus 4 is minus 9, which is equal to 0. X plus 2 whole square is equal to 9. Therefore, x plus 2 is equal to square root of 9. That means that it can be plus 3 or minus 3. Means x plus 2 can be 3 or x plus 2 can be minus 3. If this is the case, plus 2 going to that side will become 3 minus 2, x is equal to 1. In this case, minus 3 is already there. Plus 2 going to that side becomes minus 2. So your answer will be minus 3 minus 2, that is minus 5. The roots of the given equation will be x is equal to 1 or minus 5. That's it.